Ramishna Bhad Paramahansa Parivraja Kacharya Stotra Shata Nitya Leela Pravishta His Divine Grace Avaya Charnara Vinda Bhakti Vinanda Swami Srila Prabhupada Ki Jai Iskan Bibiti Fondra Chaya Param Gurude Srila Prabhupada Ki Jai Ananda Koti Vaishnu Vrinda Ki Jai God Premanandi Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya Narayanam Namaskrityam Narancaiva Narottamam Devim Sarasvatim Vyasam Tato Jaya Mudiraye Nashta Prayeshu Bhadreshu Nityam Bhagavata Sevaya Bhagavatim Uttamasloke Bhaktir Bhavati Naishtiki Just a day before Lord Chaitanya's appearance, last week we heard glorification of many associates of Lord Chaitanya. And each pastime, each exalted devotee is so exalted that any number of time we speak about them, one thing stands out is that their humility. This is the whole Lord Chaitanya's philosophy is about giving and about serving. Krishna conscious means how to serve Krishna. Krishna conscious does not mean how not to serve Krishna. So, when we are chanting the holy name of the Lord, we are engaging our souls and requesting their Lordship, please engage in your service. But when they come and give you service, at that time you are thinking something else. So, every Gaur Purnima, you can always look at what happened the whole last year. Was there any progress? Our age is catching up. But unless you catch up with Lord Chaitanya, then you will catch up with somebody else. Every day is gone. It's a great loss for us. But at the same time, if we are adding connection with the Lord, then that means we are moving towards the Supreme Lord. So, if you analyze what is Krishna conscious means, that following Guru and Krishna is Krishna conscious. There is nothing which is not incorporated in Vedic teachings or Lord's teachings, and everybody is included. One shloka of Prabodhananda Saraswati is glorifying Lord Chaitanya. He says, Patra patra vicharam na kurute nasvam param vikshayate. Deha deha vimarakshako nahiva
kala pratikshau prabho sadhyo ya shravanakshane pranamahana dhyaya dhina durlabham datta bhakti rasam sayeva bhagavan gaurav paramme gatuhu. Chaitanya Chandramrita, he is speaking. Lord Chaitanya does not consider who is worthy, who is unworthy. Who is his own, who is an outsider. Who it is to be given to and who it should not be given. Whether time is right, whether time is wrong. Lord at once gives the flavor of devotion, which is difficult to attain even by hearing the glories of the Lord, seeing the deity, offering obeisances, meditating or other practices. That Lord Gaura is our only shelter. So he does not consider who is worthy and unworthy. If you look at Srila Prabhupada's life, he was a grihastha. And there is a prediction of Lord Chaitanya, somebody is going to come and he is going to take forward this movement. They were exalted devotees, Prabhupada God brothers, Bhaktisiddhaswari Thakur, extraordinary people. But still Prabhupada was picked up, or Prabhupada took up seriously, either you can take both the ways. And so what matters is, are you going to follow your instructions of your guru? That is important. When this question was asked by Prabhupada at that time when he met that to Bhaktisiddhanta Thakur, he was telling that, you know English, you should go to the world, outside world and preach. At that time, Prabhupada said that, how can we do that? We don't have freedom. So he was looking at freedom from independence from the Britishers. So at that time, Bhaktisiddhanta Thakur, what is he telling? That these political things does not matter in Krishna consciousness. These words actually hit Srila Prabhupada in the heart. Straight away it went. Certainly, what an inspiration what he got from his spiritual master. So, a realized person in Krishna consciousness, the surrounding will not matter other than Krishna only, or his service. So, we are in that parampara, which will not, you know, you wink also, it goes outside the Lord Chaitanya's purview. And this word established, this sloka, Prabodhananda Saraswati, time and again is talking about, he's not looking at time, not looking at place, not looking at gender. So, if you are looking at, you are fortunate to be the part of this movement. How valuable you are to the movement, you may not be realizing, but the movement realizes how valuable you are all. That you will know only by the Guru. He gives you the vision. That's what Prabhupada's life between him and his Guru. His Guru saw that how valuable this wonderful jewel is. So don't think that you're ordinary. No, I cannot do this. No, doesn't matter. What Krishna thinks about you is more important. Are you ready to cooperate with his mission? That is important. The same Krishna has come as Lord Chaitanya with a different cooperating mood. Here there is no question of caste, creed, time, place. That's what he is telling here. Prabodhananda Saraswati was he was a personification of Mayavadi leader. Am I right? Huh? Prakash. Who is then Prabodhananda Saraswati? So clarification, Panditji is correcting me. So the point is, what he is trying to make is that how valuable we are, that's what it says here. So such realization, when we read such pastimes, such teachings, something should happen in our heart. We can't just go. No. There has to be some churning inside. Yes, I am valuable.
And the proof is there in front of us, pratyaksha praman, the life of Srila Prabhupada. The philosophy of Lord Chaitanya is very clear. Carrying Krishna everywhere, giving to everybody, whomever he sees, you tell him, you please chant Hare Krishna. We will read some of his pastimes and we'll meditate on that. You can see how they are so much touches our heart. The more we read about it, but it is very simple. That's the problem. The more the simpler the teachings are, the more complicated we become. So, now going to, let us see what the Bhagavatam is speaking about. He says, see, whatever I'm trying to speak, keep Prabhupada in the heart. Okay? See, we are a philosophy of Lord Chaitanya, and the present moment, he is proved that he has Prithviti Ache Nagaradigram. That's what Prabhupada has done. So we will relate everything with keeping Prabhupada in center. You know, they are extraordinary devotees. We are not going, that's all fine. But for us, is our father is important. Our grandfather is important. So this is, now Krishna is taking two slokas. What he is talking about, the Preeti aspect, the love aspect. He says, Krishna says in Bhagavatam, 9th canto, 4th chapter, 68 verse, Sadhuvo hrudayam mahyam, sadhu naam hrudayam tvam aham, mad anyate na janati, naham tebhyo manag api. The pure devotee is always within the core of my heart, and I am always in the heart of a pure devotee. My devotees do not know anything else but me, and I do not know anyone else but them. So what is this which talking about Preeti, that exhausted love between a jiva and Paramatma? And that's defined here. And you see what Prabhupada did, the instruction coming from his guru. What was he doing? There was nothing else other than how to fulfill the desire of Lord Chaitanya and his previous acharyas. And how did it happen? That happened because this is what it is. Where Ambarish, a pastime, where Durvasumuni is telling that, what I can do? I can't do anything. My devotees have conquered me. So is Prabhupada not conquered Krishna? So we are coming in that parampara. So the more we think about these things, then certainly, slowly Krishna will start come and residing in our heart. Then you will start executing what Prabhupada wants. These are very important aspects, that whether you are a husband, wife, children, anybody who can understand English, who can know about something about spiritual life, yeah, this is very simple. That's why every year when you take a stock of the last year, you will know where you're sitting. Otherwise, it is utter complacency. Don't ever think you're making any progress. No, you have to go and find out for somebody. Am I making any progress? Is there some lakshana which is coming towards? If you do not, then you can be just like that. It is a kind of an examination where you have to go and seek guidance from your seniors, from your spiritual master, whether I'm going the right direction or not. Materially, we go right or wrong, we are always wrong. But spiritually, we may be wrong or right, but under the direction of spiritual master, we are always right. Because he is there to correct us, but material life will not correct you. But spiritual life, Krishna is there to correct you. Okay, you are going in the wrong direction. I'll make sure you go that way. So concept of Krishna consciousness is just being under the shelter of Guru and Krishna and follow the instructions. So this Preeti, what is there between Krishna and his pure devotee, that guards that devotee completely. And wherever he goes, he success. And what he speaks, Krishna fulfills. One letter of Prabhupada I'll read, where he's talking about cooperation from so many people. Just because you ask cooperation, and if you don't cooperate, you are the loser. Not Prabhupada, but Krishna will send somebody else. This is where we are going, making a mistake. You have to play. I can make a little cooperation for this movement. Then Krishna is pleased. How much you make, quantum is not at all valuable. The desire is valuable. What you desire, a little bit. Let me take a step. There is correction. We have to correct our life. We are already lost in this world. We don't know where we are going. How we are going. Because we are dependent on so many external factors. Something happens 10,000 miles, we are suffering here. Some bank goes, two things happen now. One bank collapsed, so many people are crying. That means we are so much dependent on investing in where doesn't give a return, and where return comes, we are not investing. Yes, some amount of apprehension may be there. We have to do that, but that is not ultimate. The ultimate is here. Your investment has to be here. So that is a world where everything is illusion. We don't know what is the truth, whether we are in the right direction, nothing we know. So much of confusion. But here everything is very clear and straightforward. So what is the difficulty in looking at these things? Because anyhow we are aging, whenever we are closing on as age goes up. But what happens if we are not in this process? That is why, unless you think, I am the fortunate person, I am in this moment, let me capitalize. So if you don't put your money in the right place, it's going to go waste. So here, what he is talking about, Bhagavan in his highest form, that is Madhurya, it is not the object of worship, the object of love. He is not worried about bestowing gifts. He is hungrily waiting what I can offer to my devotees. He is waiting, my devotee, when he will get into problem. Let me be there, like a shadow. Here there is no question of gift, taking gift, giving. He is waiting. That means the highest love of Godhead is given by Lord Caitanya. And he wants that to be distributed everywhere. So when a person comes and surrenders with that kind of an attitude, for him, ihapara does not matter. And he may be in this world, but he is still with Krishna all the time. So the point what Prabhupada life from that day he incorporated ISKCON, from today, look at all these activities. It is towards progress, towards the strong foundation. All the pillars are strong. Many of the predictions are coming 100% true. Then devotees are happy. If we are not happy, because we are not seeing Krishna. We are not depending on Krishna. Because we are looking at material aspects, certainly they may cooperate for a certain time, but it will go off. The hard-earned money, the hard-earned sukriti. You look at these two things. The hard-earned money, the paper money. But hard-earned sukriti will lead you back to Godhead. So this is what he is talking about, that I will be the subservient of my devotees. So it's a dangerous proposition. So Maya is very careful not to let anybody into that position. So we easily fall there. If Krishna has to come and guard my house, what kind of purity should we be having? But you don't have to worry about that. You have to inch towards cooperation with that, the Guru and Krishna. That is making the difference. It's not overnight you're going to be pure. You don't have to worry. But we have to move in that direction. Okay, this is the right path. It's shown. So, next sloka, again 9463, what he is telling? Bhagavan Uvach, Aham Bhakta Paradino, Hi Ashwan Tantra Ivan Dvija, Sadhubir Grasto Hrudayo Bhaktir Bhakta Janapriya. Again, he is confirming this fact. He is the Supreme Personality of Godhead said to the Brahmana, I am completely under the control of my devotees. Indeed, I am not at all independent. Because my devotees are completely devoid of material desires, I sit only with the course of their heart. What to speak of my devotee? Even those who are devotees of my devotee are very dear to me. Here is the catch. So if you are a Prabhupada follower, you fall in this category. Is it not? I may say something wrong. It's in the Shastra. He says a person who follows him, two things are there. The bhava, what matters is whether you are in the mood of that humility. A definition of a Vaishnava is servant of a servant of a servant of a servant. Where is this identity of servant? Is it there in the heart? It is superficial. So qualification of Krishna consciousness means the mood of serving the Vaishnavas, the mood of serving the institution, the mood of cooperation with the society by and large. It's not that we bunch of people sitting here, that's it. No. Please go out. That's what our Vaishyasika Prabhu did. So it's not that, okay, everything, realization, now we are pakka, we can go, there's nothing like that. The moment you were learned your Hare, then you should go and preach about Hare. So in this so many years of Prabhupada's life, how vast the society has grown. That means many people are cooperating with Srila Prabhupada. So optimizing that is important. Samsara is not a question of tyaga. Samsara is adding Krishna into our life. It is not subtracting somebody from our life. No. Samsara is adding Krishna into our life because that is permanent. So how many proofs you want from the Bhagavatam, the Bhagavad Gita, which clearly says that how many bhavunam, janmanam, ante, gnanam, so many things are there. Vasam se jirnani. Every aspect is talking about life after life. This is the body. It keeps changing. For once, can we not become serious? Serious means, it doesn't mean that it will show up. It is the consciousness which matters. Prabhupada gives the example of a paramour love affair between an outside marriage. So a person who is very dedicated to the husband, she does everything, but still she is thinking of the other person. In the same way, can we not do this? Can we think of our Krishna still continue with our samsara? As it is happening, whether you accept it or not, you have a family. You have already a blood around you. But this blood is only water. But that blood which is coming from Krishna is the permanent blood. So intelligence is there only that person who adds Krishna into their life. So the whole mood of Krishna consciousness, Lord Chaitanya's movement is that he didn't want to leave anybody outside the purview of this mercy program. This mercy program is most important. When he went to the Jarikan forest, Lord Chaitanya, what did he do? He made every animal chant. So why did he do that? So that means he's not excluding anybody. It's proved here. So a Preeti Lakshanam is not just between Krishna and you. It is also between us. How are we reciprocating with the family? How are we looking at husband, wife, children? But there are two ways of looking at these things. One is spiritually, one is with Vyamoha. When you see with Vyamoha, then you forget Krishna. Because you have to understand they are also Krishna's children. They might have been channeled through your family. Maybe the parents. So when this Jnana Chakshu, which is coming from the Guru, will make you identify, yes, these people are going to be with me another next 50 years. Who can say 100 years they will be there? Can anybody prove? You can prove. That means unknowingly or knowingly you are accepting the fact that this person is going to go and you are also going to go. There is no return guarantee. So why not take it what Krishna says? So simple formula is Lord Chaitanya chanting the Hare Krishna mantra and act according to what it is telling you. And we have a prithvi, that means the whole world is now the Maidan for us. So every branch of ISKCON is successful. Maybe our endeavor is there, but Prabhupada's mercy, Krishna is standing behind. That's why you will find every ISKCON center is growing. Now what matters a lot is how the leadership is going to take forward. If the leadership of the temple make sure that this is the right way to go, what Prabhupada wants, then you will go in the right direction. If his priorities are different, then it goes in different direction. How will you know this? Because you're also reading Prabhupada's books. What does he want? What is he looking? So he is making sure when there is a growth of wealth, it should contribute to Krishna conscious expansion. That was the mood of Srila Prabhupada. Not a cap on the head of us. Okay, now you can sit comfortably. Vyasasa and every day you give class. There's nothing like that. So this is one of the symptoms of the leadership which will help you. Leadership is not just the managers. All of you are part of it. What is that you're guiding one society out? Every time you see some blind people going in between somebody, if they have to cross the road, somebody will come and help and go. They're not asking, but still it is coming. Where is the help coming? That means there is a humanity there. That goodness of him there in that. But spiritual blindness is not seen by anybody. Material blindness, he's a blind fellow, let me take him the other way. What happens to you when you're spiritually blind? Huh? Very dangerous, no. But Krishna is giving you that jnana chakshu for you. You open your eyes. Huh? Om ajnana timirandasya jnananjana shalakya. All of you are torch bearers. The torch bearers of Lord Chaitanya's light. So he is not exempting anybody. So we are all sitting here. There is a lot to do for this temple to grow, fulfill the desire of Lord Chaitanya. You don't have to go hundreds of miles. Prabhupada has given us enough wealth. Looking at this, what can we do? So this is a cooperation mood we require. Everyone have to look at what can I cooperate. The more we are ignorant of materialism is better for us. Because that drags us inside, it pulls us. It is andakupam. It is andakupam. Go to a person who has lost everything and talk to him. How is your life? Oh, I lost everything. He doesn't have any utsah. But go to a devotee who lost everything. He will say, thank God I am free now. I can do what I want. But it's the true fact. Because he realized the life, the true life, what is actual life? Life without Krishna is a dead body, walking dead body. A life with Krishna is the real human which is there. So this particular aspect I will want to share with you about how the interaction between Lord Chaitanya and Sanatan Goswami. Chaitanya Madhya is telling, putting a straw, please kindly attentively hear. Putting a straw in his mouth and bringing it down, Sanatan Goswami clasped the lotus feet of Lord Chaitanya and humbly spoke as follows. Sanatan Goswami said, I was born in a low family. My associates are low class men. I have myself fallen and the lowest of men. Indeed, I have passed my whole life fallen in the well of a sinful materialism. Is it true? It's not true. They were born in a rich family. They were born in a Brahmana family. Why is he telling like that? You can understand that when spiritual aspect knowledge comes, your material identity becomes zero. This is what is establishing the fact is, he's going in front of Lord Chaitanya, humbly telling that, I am nothing. This is what we are supposed to do. So when this kind of attitude comes, then Krishna Prem flows to us. We become better and better. Our relationship between us matters. You give value for it. Because Krishna is in the center. Then he goes further. He says, I do not know what is beneficial to me. I do not know what is beneficial for me, what is detrimental. Nonetheless, in ordinary dealing, people consider me as a learned scholar. I am also thinking of myself as such. So you can get carried away. Somebody comes and tells you, oh Prabhuji, you are extraordinary. Then he will not be walking in the air, he will be walking, flying in the air. Whether it's material or spiritual, he'll suddenly keep changing. Whatever it is. Because that glorification matters a lot. So the highest level of where Sanatan Goswami, Dabir Kasa and Sakar Malik, what are they were? They were actually the ministers in Muslim kingdom. Huh? They were in such a high position. This Muslim, actually very intelligent person. He know these two guys are very good. He can run. That means to say that even Muslims can identify good people and engage them for their own benefit. So this is smartness. So how you can say they didn't have everything? They had the best. But the moment they realized what is their purpose of life, it changes. So now we are reading Prabhupada books. We are reading so many, learning from so many people. A little change in our attitude, little bit. Gradually we will inch towards that. Huh? Now why is he telling that? What did Lord Chaitanya say before that? He went and told Prakashananda Saraswati, I am a fool number one. So the parampara is going, no? Why are you telling you are intelligent? It's not so. So he is telling that I am also fool number one. My Guru Maharaj told that you don't know anything, just chant Hare Krishna. So you have to be very smart into speaking to what, when, to whom you are speaking. So Lord Chaitanya's philosophy is about that, connecting with the heart, not with the body. If you identify somebody as known person, then you become familiar, then you may go around. So this is where what matters a lot is that when you start identifying with the people to heart, you have nothing to lose. You will speak your heart. There is no hidden agenda. It's clarity. Why Prabhupada was successful? He spoke the truth. But how he spoke the truth, when he spoke the truth, that was what mattered at that time. Now if you are going to expect after coming 10 years, 15 years, now I'll be very careful. I'm going to speak to these people like this. It's nothing but you're wasting your time. No, for everything there is time. There's a time where you have to become serious. If you are going to speak to somebody, if you yourself not serious, why will he take you as serious? This is our weakness. When you become 1 year senior, that means that seniority, a little bit serious you have to be. Otherwise, people will not see you as. No, he is there in this movement 5 years, 10 years, but what is the progress? No. That matters a lot. You have to understand that when we are getting educated in Lord Chaitanya's philosophy, we should also speak about it. We should also walk about it. We are not doing just lip service. We walk our talk. That was shown by Prabhupada. That was shown by other leaders. And it's not from here, right from Lord Chaitanya's time. So, I do not know out of causeless mercy, you have delivered me from materialistic path. Now by the same causeless mercy, tell me what is my duty. He had all the money with him. Everything was there. He could do his own way. But he is telling, now you tell me what I'm supposed to do. Actually, I do not know how to inquire about the goal of life and the process of obtaining it. Being merciful upon me, please explain all this truth. This is the qualification. This is the point. What is trying to, goal of life. How many of us are really bothered about it? We are complacent. Every day we are thinking, okay, this is the plan. But that plan doesn't never work. It may happen, the next day it may not happen. So our plans are all goalless. Even though it appears to be goal. This illusion of goal. And even if your goal is there, the goalpost may change. The ball is coming and going to fall, but somebody removes the goalpost. That's what happened to her, this world. We always plan our things, but somebody else will come and disturb. Huh? How many of you think it's okay? Goalpost changing. That is how the Maya illusion comes, which will take you, okay, tomorrow is one more day. Let me try one more. So you can go on. But why not with Krishna once? Let me give one life to Krishna. Let us see what happens. This is not fool number one. So important for all of us is first set our goal. It could be a short-term goal. It could be a long-term goal. Long-term goal, short-term goal, one common factor is going back to Krishna. Is that should be there. The short-term goals, maybe you have many other things to do. But it cannot be the priority. It could be sub-priority. So there are certain things we have to do. That is a natural thing. That was done by Lord Chaitanya. Why am I telling this point is when Lord Chaitanya, when his father died, his mother was helpless. She wanted him to get married. Lord Chaitanya fulfilled it. So fulfilling the desire of the mother or the parents is in our parampara, which is in tune with what we are supposed to do. You understand? That is important. They ask you something else which you cannot do. No, I have to fulfill. Then that won't work. So a parent desiring the son or the daughter to get married is a natural thing. That's what it is. The life is over. So Lord Chaitanya's, if you see his pastimes, every aspect he fulfilled the desire of the parents. One instance I remember about Lord Chaitanya, when his brother took sannyas, the parents decided, oh, if you make my second son educated, he will also become sannyas. So they didn't send him to school. Look at Lord Chaitanya, how he teaches the parents. This is smartness. This is a smartness in our life, we should be in family life. How you can confuse people into Krishna consciousness, not material consciousness. So what did Lord Chaitanya do? He became a boy, very naughty. He used to do so much of give problem to everybody. You can see the pastimes where everybody was disturbed by his mood. Somebody he would go pull the panche. Somebody he would put, I'm your husband. So many things are there in the nice pastimes of Lord Chaitanya. So when you see all that, and one day he was sitting where all the pots were for washing and broken. He was sitting there. The mother comes and says, "Were you sitting here?" He says, "What is the difference between this and that? It's okay. I'm not an educated person." Well, look at that. This is how he confused the parents to send him to the school. Is it not smartness? So this is our life is material world. We have to look at various ways and means to confuse the materialistic people. It could be our parents. It could be our relatives. It could be our bosses. It could be anybody else. To Krishna consciousness, that which will not affect them. Any act we do keeping Krishna in the center, it will not affect the the people around us. Materially it will affect, not spiritually. So then he went start going to the school. So the nature of a jiva, right from Krishna to the downtrodden, is that we have to follow certain rules and regulations. That's the natural process. Now he is asking here, please help me with the goal of life. Now what is this goal of life? What Mahaprabhu explained, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu said, Lord Krishna has bestowed his full mercy upon you so that all these things are known to you. For you, the three miseries certainly do not exist. Since you possess Lord Krishna's potency, you certainly know these things. However, it is the nature of sadhu to inquire. Although he knows these things, the sadhu inquires for the sake of strictness. What is he highlighting is, any number of times you hear the Bhagavatam, it will strengthen you, you will not get bored. Got the point? That's what he's telling. You know everything, but still you want to hear from me. Why? Because it strengthens our internal consciousness. The more we hear about the Lord's pastimes, the more the people who are serving him, we also get that mood. So here, Lord Chaitanya knows that you know everything, but still you want to hear from me. So that is the quality of a sadhu. We sit in the house, call up, today who is giving Bhagavatam class? Oh, I can go a little late, no problem. That means you already convinced that this fellow doesn't know anything. And he is, that means you have a choice to decide what you want to hear. You don't have a choice, you are not looking at a choice, what the Bhagavatam wants to give you. This is the quality, this is the taste what we are not getting. The moment you take up a phone, the moment you choose a speaker on the wall, yeah, there will be good speakers, there could be other. But there is something for them to give, he is not concocting anything. From A to Z, devotee is a devotee. Yeah, some people may speak a little bit more and he may give, but that doesn't mean the other person doesn't speak. So here what he is establishing, Sanatana Goswami is telling, no, I don't know anything, you please explain to me. So this is our humility of hearing. One is humility of speaking, one is humility of serving, hearing. The moment you think about a speaker, what he is speaking, whether it is good for me or not, that means you are a judgmental. It's very dangerous. He a person, temple is authorized, he's sitting, whatever he speaks, it is in the parampara. If there is something different, you ask a question and get clarity. That is all. But you don't have a right to doubt that integrity of that person who is sitting on the Vyasasana. That is the duty of a person who sits on the Vyasasana, what he is going to deliver. What is he going to speak? Whether it is realization or he will mug and come and speak here. That is his problem, not yours. So every aspect of hearer, speaker, each one's responsibility. Don't exchange that with, I have a responsibility today, I have to share something about Lord Chaitanya. Now I have not decided what you're going to hear from me. So it is in tune to accept this fact. Yes, today is, tomorrow is Lord Chaitanya's pastimes. I mean, he's going to take birth. So today we are preparing to understand the Lord Chaitanya's mood. So that's what is binding us for you to come here. Our temple is supporting it. So you are fit to, he says, you are fit to propagate the cult of devotional service. Therefore, gradually hear all the truths about it from me. I shall tell you about them. So living entity's constitutional position to be eternal servant of Krishna. First point Lord Chaitanya is making. Living entity's constitutional position to be eternal servant of Krishna. What is that? Jivere Swarup Hoy. What is the difficulty in understanding? If you go further, it says, not just servant, servant of a servant of a servant, it says. So your identity is established on your forehead. I am a servant, never think you are a boss. Always be eager to serve the other, whether it is husband, whether it is wife, everybody's identity is same. That's how you will feel when you go among the Vaishnavas. Each will be trying to catch other feet. That is the nature. Nobody is thinking, I know better than you. No. So, this is the first thing what Krishna is speaking about. Lord Chaitanya is telling Lord Sanatana Goswami, you are the eternal servant of Krishna. So, this is fixed. And what does Krishna says? That if you are eternal servant of Krishna, that means you and me are already united together. The earlier time, what we read, how Prabhupada became, Krishna became the servant of Prabhupada in making his a desire to fulfill Lord Chaitanya's mission. That's what is happening. Now Chandradev Mandir is coming up. Was Prabhupada told his one disciple, you please build this temple. How you get the money, he didn't know. Some of you also have contributed. Prabhupada came and told you what? It's very simple, no? That means to say, when a pure devotee thinks of something, money will come, the temple will come up. So this is pratyaksha praman, is there in front of you. That means we are in the right direction. It will convince you to, conviction become very, very strong in your heart. Yeah, we are in the right direction. Prabhupada is that person who is doing it. And why such a beautiful temple? Are you not going to go and enjoy that? Somebody, how many people are building houses around that? What for? That means the direction what you are looking at, oh, eternal happiness with the Supreme Lord. So if that doesn't happen here, why will that happen in the spiritual world? So this is what we have to look at. If you do not make this the happy mood along with the philosophy of Lord Chaitanya, if you don't engage there, then how can it happen in the spiritual world? So, the truth is there in eating right now. And every day is a new hope. Every day you get up in the morning is a chance for you. Okay, today is one more day for me. At the end of the day, I lost one more day. This is what is happening in our life. We go to the bank, deposit. Next day we go and remove. That's what is happening in our karma. We do some good karma, some bad karma, every day putting in. But when you do devotional service, there is no only fixed deposit. That bank will not fail. There is no yes bank. Yes bank failed, no bank. The name is yes bank, but it became no bank. So many lives are finished. What is that you, only devotees of Lord can understand that and learn from their mistakes. Why is it not happening? So this requires a strong association, strong understanding of philosophy. That makes the change in life. Devotees are there 30 years, 40 years, 50 years. How come they are there? What is that keeping them together? That's Prabhupada's mercy. Irrespective of even they slip out, they come back. So all our convictions become stronger when we read Prabhupada Lilamrit and compare it with what I think many of you attended the Founder Acharya series. Anybody here? What did you feel? Did it enhance your love for Prabhupada? Did it bring you near Prabhupada? So if that is happening within 10 days and if every day you are looking at what Prabhupada then purports, what will happen to you? You see? So the next point what Lord Chaitanya is talking about is, it is the living entity's constitutional position to be eternal servant of Krishna, because he is the marginal energy of Krishna, a manifestation simultaneously one with and different from Lord, like a molecular particle of sunshine or fire. Krishna has three varieties of energy. So he goes on like that. So what is he making? That you are a part and parcel of Krishna. The servant is a part of that. So, Krishna has three varieties. Just as an illumination of a fire, which is situated in one place, is spread all over, the energies of the Supreme Personality of God at Parabrahman are spread all over this universe. So, this is looking at the Lord Chaitanya's we will just go to some pastimes of the Lord, which will remembering Lord Chaitanya. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was born in Mayapur in town of Nadia, 23rd Falgon, 1407, advent of and I'll just go small we'll take it up and we'll go to the some pastimes. To 18 February 1486, the moon was eclipsed at the time of his birth, and the people of Nadia were engaged as usual as such occasions in taking bath in Ganges. Loud cheers of Haribol. His father Jagannath Mishra, a poor Brahmin of Vedic order, mother Sachi Devi was a model of a good woman, both descended from the Brahminical stock originally residing in Silyat. Mahaprabhu was a beautiful child, and ladies of town came to see him with presents and his mother's father. Pandit Nilambar Chakravarti, a renowned astrologer, foretold that the child would be a great personage in time, and therefore he gave him the name Vishwambar. The ladies of the neighborhood called him Gaurahari on account of his golden complexion, and the mother called him Nimai on the account of the neem tree where he was born. So already there were three names. So there was a little between what name we have to give. So Lord Chaitanya took all the three names. It's so difficult to have 10 children die off. Huh? And the 11th one, she's praying, you better, you know, it's impossible for a mother to lose so many. But the hope of having that son, what is all there? So this is the natural bhava of a mother to have kids. The progeny should go. So after 10, and one more thing happened was that this child was not coming out after 9 months also. Sitting there inside. So they were worried. What's going to happen? If it was in today's time, before that only. See, he's already showing the hand like this. The weight of the body has to come out. So that time there was no cesarean. It was a natural thing. So they waited. So Nilambar Chakravarti said, don't worry. The Lord is waiting for that auspicious time to come out. Nowadays, we are waiting for that day, which one, Ekadashi, they go to the hospital and get it cesarean done. This is not the way. No. Then they will say, my boy is born on Ekadashi. Many people do that. It's a natural thing. We did not know what was cesarean in our times. Nowadays, even devotees choose the day, time, everything, and they go. What can we say? What impacts is the consciousness what you have, not the time of your birth. In this regard, this one last 3 days, I think 4 or 5 days back, one devotee, Lakshmi Narayan, passed away. Extraordinary devotee. I've been watching him since quite a long time. He's an ideal husband and wife family. Every time I used to walk here, and husband would come in the front, she would walk at the back. 7 o'clock. What is their age? 80 plus. Dedicated wife. Just follow the husband, how is he going? So I asked how this happened, when did he leave? They told me that the wife was actually reading Bhagavatam. And while reading, gradually Lakshmi Narayan was not there. So you can see two types of Savitris are here. One Savitri brought husband back from Yamaloka. One Savitri sent him to Vaikuntha. Who can see that as wife sits and reads Bhagavatam patiently with a vegetable in the front? What matters is the heart. She recognizes my husband. My duty is to read. And she read Bhagavatam. I don't know when he passed away. So, 100%, somewhere or the other, in that period, he must have heard the Bhagavatam. Why did this happen? How did this happen? If you look at this, another pratyaksha praman, because their service attitude. Which was the day you didn't see them there? Did any one day they came and cried here? Oh, I'm old. I've been serving there. Nobody's helping me. Did they say any time? What else you want? A nice devotee, a nice family. This can be a cue for us. How we are going to be with that? How many tubes with us? We don't know. So what matters is the relationship is between heart to heart, husband and wife. Heart to heart between mother and parents. So that is what is Krishna conscious about. You have pramana in the front, but still doesn't register in our head. Manda sumanda madayo. So these things are example for us to move on. How do we move on? What else pramana you want? That his wonderful family, how they left. He's nothing left in this. Everything was done. So there is no question of crying. Crying of separation. We may miss him there. But what a way to leave the body. I was talking about the education aspect. Right? So this is how Lord Chaitanya made sure that every time he would educate the parents to push him so that he does the right thing. Then furthermore, another wonderful thing happened. When Lord Chaitanya was there in the womb of Mother Sachi, she became beautiful, most wonderful person. And Jagannath Mishra came and said, "You look very beautiful." They were interacting like that. At that time, lot of many miracles were happening. Bright light, suddenly yellow light around, and lot of good things are happening. And the sound, explained in like Chaitanya Charitamrita, it says, there was some interaction which was happening. And what was this interaction is, the devatas are coming and praying to Lord Chaitanya, what mistake we have done that we are not going to take birth, you are going to elevate all these people who are there in Kali Yuga, what mistake we have done. We have two problems. What are the two problems? Time and again these demons come and harm us. The second one is still more dangerous, too much of material opulence. Who will say this? Too much of material opulence. I don't think we have upper limit in this world. There is no upper limit in this world. So they are telling that we can't, so much of sense gratification we cannot think. Please do something for us. At that time, Lord Chaitanya said, "All right, all of you take birth." Right from Brahma, Shiva, all the people, all the devatas took birth. So the present demigods are not those demigods. They all went back to Godhead. They went back with Lord Chaitanya. This is the fresh who are there. Because people who take part Lord Chaitanya's pastime will not come back here. They will go to the spiritual world. So this was an opportunity where Krishna gave, "All right, take birth." So if devatas are telling all this, why should we worry? We have such wonderful knowledge, wonderful infrastructure, wonderful Prabhupada teachings, so many wonderful devotees. Everything is there. They're all showing us the direction. Why pain in the heart of materialism? A little 10 minutes, 15 minutes, 1 hour, 2 hours of your time among devotees, encash it. Don't repent. When you come to the temple, don't come, "Oh my God." No, come, "My God, I have to come." It should be the other way. Because we are never tired of materialism, but we are tired of our 16 rounds. We are waiting to put that 16 round back there. We are waiting to close the Bhagavatam when we'll have prasadam. So many things are there. This kind of material despondency is very dangerous. So this is one symptom where you can extend half an hour of hearing, that's progress. If you estimate 1 hour of Bhagavatam, your daily you're reading, after 1 year, it becomes 1 hour, 5 minutes, that is progress. But if from 1 hour, it becomes 5 minutes less, then dangerous. That means we are not. So, if you are asking me today, what are the symptoms of progress of devotional service, is when your enthusiasm becomes better in hearing, chanting, serving, is the qualification, is that symptom. No other symptom, nobody has to come and show you the mirror. It is there with you. Today is Ekadashi. I'm chanting 5 more rounds. So when there is pleasure in that, in the beginning you may have austerity, but there it is not like that. Just two devotees have come from other part of India and they are staying in another temple. So it was Ekadashi, one of our God brother, he was asked to cook Ekadashi Prasad for them. But they said that today is Ekadashi, we are going to chant 50 rounds. So we will have minimum. It could have been other way. So that is the cue. Oh, a senior devotee at that age, he is past 70. He wants to do 50 rounds and he wants to have prasad only and juice. So that means to say it is not the body strength, it is the heart strength, which is their inner one. So this is the symptom of understanding, oh, a devotee, he is making progress. There is nothing else. If your companion can make better off, that is a chance for you to understand, oh, he is making progress. Why is he making a progress? Why I am not making? You don't have to require any other praman. Because we go back to our world, we forget this world, we get lost. No happiness the other way. So now coming to Lord Chaitanya, coming to the his educational aspect, is one of the wonderful things. He's such an extraordinary, within the age of 14, he was a master of everything. But mind that his humility was there as it is. He would defeat people. At the same time, he would correct them. And also he would tell them, you're correct. Who can do that? He is giving them all opportunity to learn, to understand, also to glorify what you are doing is correct. Complete by itself. So, that is another quality of Lord Chaitanya, where he would correct everybody, whether it is senior or junior. So many devotees who were all there, they were thinking that Lord Chaitanya is so much good in grammar, nyaya, all this. But if Krishna would be in his heart, would the best? Look at that, what they are thinking. He is Supreme Lord himself. He has come for the purpose of this. Still devotees are thinking, if Krishna would be in his tongue, it would have been better. If he would have been a devotee. What is it? Love or affection, or it is ignorance? I will leave it to you to decide. Because these are extraordinary people. Just before that, when Prabhupada was seeking many things, look at Advaita Acharya. His powerful prayer brought Lord Krishna himself here. So prayers are very powerful. Whether you, anybody else, when you pray with sincerity, it produces. It is 100% it produces the result required. But the difference is it for you or is it for the society? That matters a lot. When you pray for the institution, when you pray for the society, that makes the difference. So the social service, a devotee is always selfless. There is no questioning for him about thinking about himself. He's always thinking about others, welfare of others. The moment he realizes. So here Lord Chaitanya's mood was like that, in such a way that when he defeated, when the news came that there is a Pandit who is going to come, and he is extraordinary Digvijay Pandit. All of you know the story, but what is that we are going to learn from there? That is the most important thing. So any amount of knowledge, if it is not under the feet of ours, it will be detriment to you. Never put that on your head. Ahankar. The knowledge of ego should never be on the head. It should be at the foot. So this is what matters is when this Digvijay Pandit was going around, the knowledge was there in the heart. What did Lord Chaitanya do? He would have killed him. But he killed the spirit. He took him to his side, sat with him, with a humble mood, educated him. And the next day he surrendered to him. So this is the mood we have to take in when we are interacting with devotees. The moment you say, our philosophy is the best, we have everything, you don't know anything, when you start speaking in this, people will distance you. So you should find a way how to attract those people. That's why Prabhupada started with Gulab Jamun. Pet se dimag. Pehle pet ko deo, dimag jito badna. So when person becomes happy with a nice sumptuous prasad, then be ready to hear. Because he comes to the yoga nidra. So Lord Chaitanya's dealing with Keshav Kashmiri was such that he corrected him, and the next day he came and surrendered that you are. So Nimai Pandit, from that day onwards, he became very famous. Panditji. Anybody would see Lord Chaitanya would go, what this year? They would turn their face and go off that side. Because he's going to catch him. He caught hold of Srivas, he caught hold of Gadadhar. So many people he caught hold, and he would debate with them, defeat them. Again, he would defeat himself. Again, he would do that. So people were thinking, they were all nice Vaishnavas. Oh, if at all, if he becomes a Vaishnav, what it would be? So looking at all these aspects, there was a time where a great festival was going on. In that festival, where Jagannath Mishra and Sachi Mata was celebrating at that time, Ishwarapuri also had to come there for that festival. The big feast. When Ishwarapuri saw Lord Chaitanya, he could understand, here is the Supreme Personality of Godhead has come. They were just eye to eye match. He didn't stay there, then he left. So looking at all these aspects, we will come to the pastime of Lord Chaitanya, where his father died. When his father died, he got married, but he thought, let me go and do pindadan. Let me offer praise to my ancestors. That is another aspect of following the Vedic system. So, the pindadan is for Brahmanas. It is natural thing for them to do every year, and to go to Gaya, go to Puri in different places. But Lord Chaitanya's mood of going to Gaya was a different aspect. He had come to now realize that all these people who are around me are not going to associate with me. Now I have to change my mood. So on the way he's going, so many things happen, and in the process he's coming to Bodh Gaya, Vishnu Gaya, and he sees the lotus feet of Lord Vishnu, and continuous water is coming, and with that water it is cleaning the Lord's lotus feet. At that time Ishwarpuri was there. Then he goes and surrenders to Ishwarpuri. Before that, it is actually the Lord's wish that he desires to hear from somebody. So he gives the mantra to him before, and he gives back. But it appeared that he was initiated by Ishwarpuri. The moment Ishwarpuri gave him this Maha Mantra, the whole paradigm shift was there in Lord Chaitanya's life. He became mad. He became mad that he didn't know what he was doing. What was night, what was day, whether he was eating, not eating. How many of us got the Hare Krishna mantra if this happened? japite japite pagal ho gaya. He became mad after just the more he hears about Lord Chaitanya. Don't worry, the symptoms are there. It is going to reveal. Each one of us, it will reveal. Because we are in the queue. We are in the process of sadhana bhakti. It is there. But the proof is here. The proof is there with Prabhupada. He also got it. And what happened to him? So everyone has a role to play. Provided you want to cooperate. Lord is there for your cooperation. He is two hands. Come on, I'm ready. But we are not ready. So our cooperation is the paramount for this relationship. Because he is already sold out. So now Lord Chaitanya, when he comes back to look at, even that time people thought he was mad. So when he came back, he was just chanting this holy name. He was moving around, falling Vaishnava's dust. Before people who would avoid, he would go and catch their feet. Oh, great Vaishnava, Gadadhar, Shiva, so many people he was doing, holding their legs. At that time, many people were running something wrong with this. Someone went even told Sachimata, some bhoot preth may be there. Better do some purification process. So when all these were happening at that time, then Mother Sachi somehow met Srivas. He called Srivas. Srivas, because she had trust in him. What happened to your friend? Suddenly he's become like this. Can you do something? So when Srivas went to Lord Chaitanya, and Lord Chaitanya is asking him, Srivas, people call me, I'm mad. Please tell me, am I really mad? I'm just chanting the holy name of Lord Krishna's past times I'm remembering. But these people calling me mad. I've got this disease. What is this disease? Srivas immediately understood. Oh, this is the disease everybody should have. This is the disease that everybody should have that we are not able to recognize. Then he comes and tells Mother Sachi, no, he's normal, don't worry. So from there onwards, everybody starts relating Advaita Acharya. That's where Shiva Sangan start the holy name. Where every night, Shiva's Advaita, everybody, Haridas Thakur, all these people would assemble, sit there, and every night the Kirtan program started. Harinam Sankirtan program started from there. So not only Lord Chaitanya got infected with disease, he also infected others into this disease, but not this virus. Present virus. That was bhakti virus. Huh? That is bhakti virus where the Lord Chaitanya says infected all over the world. Huh? So we have to look at how this bhakti virus will go to every house here. So this bhakti virus, if this bhakti virus, which is coming from the transcendental world, the proof how this can happen, let us just see what has happened just about a month back, what happened in China. That's about 10,000 kilometers from here, China. 10,000. Somebody did something, we are getting affected. When that virus can come from there, where we have not seen at all, then why can't we understand bhakti virus, which is coming from Goloka Vrindavan? Enough proof? Huh? You don't have to wear mask. You don't have to clean your hands. You don't have to, shake hands. Namaste. Don't have to do anything. But still this virus opened out. So bhakti virus, slowly Navadvip Mandal became fully infected with this. And Lord Chaitanya was the epitome of that center of Harinam. It is not that Lord Chaitanya was not criticized. There were many other people who criticized Lord Chaitanya's way of doing things because they lost their business. For everything they would say, chant Hare Krishna, everything will be okay. So everybody forgot everything. Every day, chant Hare Krishna. But the pandit who were making money at that time, they went and told the Raja, is something, our business is gone. do something. This boy is come and destroying all our business. Huh? Nowadays, mask business has become very big. Mask? 2 rupees ka 18 rupees. See how the world is. There are people who make money out of disease. This is the material world. You are trusting them. Padam padam yad vipanam. Those people must be putting that virus in a, what is that, a photo and album and daily doing worship, that medical practitioner, because so many of his mask is going. So here is a person who is happy with that virus. This is material world. Right? Somebody is suffering, he is enjoying. He didn't ask for it, but it has come. That means this prarabdha karma, we don't know how it will come. It will come in the form of virus, and you make money and he suffers. So, unless this happens, majjida madgata prana, people will be destroyed. Their life is gone and you will be the cause for it. You have to make sure that you do something for at least a few people around you to change their life. They have to become Krishna consciousness. Each one, teach one. But do it the right way, not the wrong way. What is the right way? That the humility aspect, which is very, very important. So when Lord Chaitanya, how did he, when he came to know that Nawab, he came and you know what happened with Lord Chaitanya. He just took non-violence at that time only. He started this non-violence movement. Mridangam, Kartal, they went and did a big Harinam in front of that Kazi. What happened to Kazi? He also got infected with holy name. It's such a nice pastime. Each one of you can go through. I think time is running out. So the point is, Lord Chaitanya, he is, just now, earlier I read, he doesn't leave anybody, whether it's a Muslim or a Christian. He's not going to spare anybody. Everybody is a jivatma and he's going to communicate with them. Only thing is, how we are going to do it? And that's what is happening in this world today. That somewhere or the other, the holy name is going on. So this Prithvi Che Ache Nagaradigram is fulfilled by that Srila Prabhupada, and we are in that parampara. You should understand that we are, our lineage is extraordinary. The more you realize this, the more better for you. The faster you realize this, the betterment of the society. How are you going to do it? That is for you to debate, deliberate, and see what we are going to do. Our Prabhuji shortly is coming up with a two-paper newsletter that what we are here for. Just like Sanatana Goswami is asking Lord Chaitanya, what is my purpose? People should know, what is the purpose of ICC sitting here? What do you say, Suvarnan Gaurav? So he is going to be that epitome of communicating with everybody, that we are here for your service, not that the other way. So already from last month, it has started happening. So now you have to sit and meditate on how you can communicate with people around us, how they can become happy, how this area can become blissful. It's not a one man, it's a total cooperation movement. Don't ever think in your house, okay, if I do this, that's it. No, you have to come out of your house. If you don't come out, Maya will throw you out. Better voluntarily you take Krishna's surrender, no? Now, I will come to the point of where Lord Chaitanya's pastime coming to Jagannath Puri. This pastime of Lord, of one of our pillars is cleanliness. So this was highlighted by Lord Chaitanya. Antaranga Shuddhi, Bhairanga Shuddhi, both are very equally important. This 24 years what he spent in Jagannath Puri is that he communicated the bhakti aspect, how to worship Krishna, How to bring him to your heart, not to the temple as such. It is not that we are having a nice temple, things like that. But when you go, you're going to carry that Lord in your heart. This was shown by Lord Chaitanya when this pastime of Gundicha Marjanam. So when Gundicha Marjanam was started by Lord Chaitanya, the moment Lord was going to come there, Lord Chaitanya planned a very nice purification for all of them. He said, Lord is going to come. Let's all sit together and clean this place. And he inspired everybody, but he was in the front. So leadership is that. He has to stand in the front, get things done, and also do it. Not that you stand at the back and get things done. That is material leadership. Spiritual leadership is we are blended with the other people. So here was the place where he called everyone, gave them all the necessary aspects of cleaning. And it took 2 days. Cleaning? 1 day. 1 day, whole day was meant for cleaning. And in the process of cleaning, you could see many people were cleaning others' lotus feet. That's the catch. That's the catch. That means to say, our fellow brothers and God sisters, identify your neighbor, they are not ordinary souls. So we may have our own anarthas. Doesn't matter, ignore it. In the jubilation, we can forget. In the mood of festivals, we can forget our whatever differences are there. Because festivals, everything comes together. So our mood is only of serving. So when Lord Chaitanya was doing this, that everybody was mood of finer and finer and finer. So this is another point for us to understand is there is no end limit for becoming finer. When Lord Chaitanya met Rupa Goswami and he was expressing that, he went and embraced him full of pus and things like that. But Rupa Goswami was telling that, what are you doing, my Lord? I'm the most fallen. Lord Chaitanya said that, don't break my heart with your humility. These are the words he's using. Break my heart with your humility. It's the epitome. So how humility is most important for us in practicing devotional service. So our interaction with devotees is very important. How we deal with somebody comes for a cash to give. You should be humble enough to treat him that way. In the same way, when he gives the receipt, the way you take the receipt makes the difference. Somebody is coming with a plate of prasadam, you go on to give. When you tuck, you put. Or you put with a smiling face. Makes the difference. Every activity with a beautiful smile, even though kota may be inside heart, but still it is better than khane ke liye aage idhar, kuch nahi karta. Heart mein rakho parwa nahi, but serving smilingly. Because one day he will change. We have seen in ISKCON earlier time many times, people have taken four years, they have not done anything, but fifth year they have become transcendental. They have become extraordinary devotees. So we cannot time it. Arey baba, tumhara bap ka ja raha hai, tumhara kya problem hai? Arey, he is the one who is giving. Suddenly you become the owner with that bucket. What an ego. The bucket and you're serving. What an unnatural behavior. Is it natural? Nothing is yours. Even bucket is not yours. So what matters a lot is every action of yours can bind people or break people. Keep this in your mind. Every act what we do, because you are the custodian of legacy of the Lord and Prabhupada's, If a devotee walks off the temple because of your misbehavior, unknowingly to chodo, knowingly to karo mat, then what happens? That devotee will never come back. So, phook phook ke paav rakhna. That means you should be very careful in dealing with Vaishnavas. That is what Lord Chaitanya showed here. Says very, very, but he says mad elephant. Vaishnava Prad is mad elephant. It will destroy the any number of tapas, austerities you do, or Govardhan Parikram. Every year you go 24 kilometers, don't eat anything. 1 minute will go off by doing some Vaishnava Prad without knowing and knowing. Don't think it's a joke. At least knowingly don't do it. Because unknowingly we don't know. So there is a correction process. We are not perfect. But if our mind is thinking that I want to give my best, don't worry, Krishna will back you. Krishna will back us because he needs, sees your sincerity. He doesn't see your intensity of showing everybody I am the best server here. That is visible to them. But Krishna only sees how much you are sincere inside the heart. Because he's sitting in your heart. Andar aadmi baith gaya means what you can do? Person who is sitting in your heart, you can't cheat him. So that matters a lot. So when Lord Chaitanya showing this extraordinary behavior of Lord Rupa Goswami, he says, enough, enough. So these are the standards which we have to meditate on how to go about. And what did Lord Chaitanya do with Haridas Thakur? Please meditate on this particular pastime. It will purify our heart. Supreme Personality of Godhead goes to Jagannath Temple, take the Mahaprasad. Before honoring, he comes to Lord Haridas Thakur and says, you take this Mahaprasad, then I will take. What is this behavior of Lord? Is this not enough for us to learn? The relationship of Vaishnavas is extraordinary. Every act of, whether it is Haridas Thakur, he is thinking, I am in a Mohammedan family. I cannot, he could go, he is Brahma himself. We could walk to Jagannath Temple. So we have to identify our constitutional position where we are in. And we have to react about it. So, two extraordinary people. One is the humility of showing, and another one is service attitude. He comes with Mahaprasad. Now you eat, and they both would honor Prasad together and go. So what was the result of all this? Haridas Thakur said, my dear Lord, I want to pass away before you go. You please fulfill it. And Lord Chaitanya said, yes, it will happen. Can you imagine? Lord Chaitanya puts his leg on the chest of Haridas Thakur and he leaves. What is the difference between Lakshmi Narayan's death and this, where his wife is reading Bhagavatam and leaves this world? Is it the same? There is no Beda with Lord. What is Beda? That is in this material world. In terms of Lord, everybody is the same. You reciprocate, he gives you back. So, but there's a variety. Each one is a variety. But Lord Chaitanya's movement, two things are very important. Their humility and their humbleness. And their commitment to the service, epitome of service. So that is the difference between the Vaikuntha and the Goloka Vrindavan. So these are the differences. That is all. But here not, we are not here to debate that. But we are here to understand this is the easiest way. Aray chaprasi banke Bhagavan ka paas jayenge na. Because tum to upar baith gaya to nahi jayega. The moment you get attached to this chair which is there, you will not come out, hey, achha hai chair. It's very dangerous. Sometimes some people sit in only one place. Very comfortable there. I don't know what is comfortable. I tried to sit there, but it didn't work out. Many times it happens. They get attached to one place. Maybe some magnet down. That's why sannyasis never stayed in one place. They would move from one place like that. That is why any activity which binds us to one seat is dangerous. Kabhi kabhi aage bhi baith jao. So, nature of the living entity in the material world is to accumulate position. Nature of the living entity in the spiritual world is to serve the position. You understand the difference? Material world, position mein baith jao. Spiritual world mein position ko serve karo. Akela hai Ishwara, aur sab bhratya. Simple, but doesn't go to the heart. So the more we meditate on Lord Chaitanya's pastime, our heart gets purified. That's why Lord Chaitanya, he did not talk anything about the Adananda Shikshastaka. He would tell Nityananda, please go door to door, beg them to take up the Krishna consciousness. Don't we beg our children, please study, what all we do to them? So in spiritual aspect, this is what the guru does. He keeps telling that these people are agnana, they are in the mode of ignorance. Get them out, it's not easy. Do something, nice kirtan, nice prasad, nice, so many things. That's why Prabhupada was the master of cheater. Material world cheaters are there, right? To get those cheaters into this temple is not easy. And he cheats them to become good devotees. And I am one among them. So, Prabhupada is not an ordinary person. He is extraordinary and he is our founder, Acharya. So the more we concentrate on what Prabhupada did and read the pastime of Lord Chaitanya and the present, if you connect these things, you will know how Prabhupada carried Lord Chaitanya in his heart from the parampara. That's why I read those two slokas. It was not Krishna who was sitting, it was Lord Chaitanya who was sitting in the heart of Prabhupada. He went everywhere. Even though Prabhupada landed in Moscow, he was not allowed to go outside. 2-3 days he walked, but that made the difference. Wherever probably Prabhupada would have flied over Bangalore somewhere. That's why some dust has fallen here. So Krishna consciousness is taking place. So pure devotee, wherever they go, mantra upasaka, wherever they go, like Ganges, bhakti flows. But bhakti flows doesn't mean that you sit here, everything will happen. You will also have to take one. What is that? What does Balaram carry? Plow. So you will also carry from your heart to another heart, not to kill somebody. Make way for the flow of that bhakti to go. Here are they, their lordships, waiting to give the mercy to everybody. But unfortunately, they are stuck with us. Now, unfortunately, we have to make it fortunately by the sukriti of extraordinary devotees who are coming to our temple and making the difference. So in this way, where Lord Chaitanya cleaned up the whole temple, I think today we have a cleaning program. Oh, it's coinciding. You better make sure you have many people join you. So when Lord Chaitanya's heap was the biggest heap, in the same way, what do we understand is the anarthas which is in a heart, we know it very. He may not know what is there in my heart, but I know what is in my heart. But that is, that what is there in your heart, whether is in tune with parampara, that what matters. If something else is filled up in your heart, then it will not come out. So cleaning the heart is sadhaka. When he starts doing externally and internally, two things. The third one is, you should go and approach another person. Am I doing good? May tikhu kya? Am I be all right? Whether your counselor, that senior devotee, or your guru, your shiksha guru, or your dear friend, unless you ask, maybe your husband can ask the wife can ask the husband, How was the food today? Was it properly offered to Krishna? So you can look at these aspects, and the outcome of that, you see what will happen. The day the wife comes and asks the husband, it's happening, I'm not doubting that. But once you ask, and he reciprocates, I think Krishna must be pleased. Why do you say that? Because I got pleased. That makes the difference. So the love or affection, whatever you are doing, it's not material. It is spiritual. Because Jiva is sitting in this body, as long as the food given, Jiva is surviving in this body. Body may be perishing, but Jiva is not perishing. So whatever you cook food, you offer to the Lord, that is Mahaprasad, which goes to the Jiva, to the heart. So it actually gives you the strength. If at all today we are here, the tapasya, what you have done from so many years, it's producing the results. So that bhakti lata beej, which is growing in our heart, make sure it gets cut in the right place. If you allow it, it can grow anywhere. It's a mad elephant. So great opportunity for tomorrow, for all of us to pray that we can, I thought we can have more kirtan, because so many activities will be there. By a nice kirtan, make this Srivas Angan tomorrow. What do you think? With Lord Chaitanya and Nityananda Abhishekam going on, let us take the mood of that Srivas Angan night and create a vibrant atmosphere, and let's take that for the next year. We'll make it much better. What do you think? It's a good idea. Thank you very much. Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare, Hare Rama, 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 Hare Hare.